Body battery is basically a combined score or analytic that looks at your heart rate, your stress, your activity, your sleep over a period of time, and it comes up with a score to indicate what your energy level is. Zero is going to be the lowest, 100 is going to be the highest. I think of it in terms of a gas tank. If you've got a 100 score on your body battery, you've got a full energy gas tank. If you're closer to zero, you're lower on energy. And basically what you use it for is to determine whether or not you need to be getting more rest or relaxation, or whether you should get out and do some exercise or some work because you've got energy. So anyway, enough talking about it. Let's look at the widget. I've got it added as the first widget in my widget wheel. So this is what we're looking at. If you go at it, this is the icon for the body battery. When you go into it, you're gonna see basically a trend over the last 4 hours. So over the last 4 hours, the highest I've been is at 58. The lowest I've been is at 35. When we're in here, other than this screen, you can press the GPS button and you can see the trend with stress. You can see that 50, here's the same graph that we saw for me over the last 4 hours, but you can also see my stress levels mixed in there as well. I can press the down arrow and I can see what I've gained or lost since midnight of the current day. So today I've gained 4 and I've lost 48 points in my body battery. That's really about all you can see on the widget. Again, you can press the back button to go back to your last 4 hour trend. That's how you look at the body battery on the watch. So one of my favorite features on the watch is the temperature setting, temperature sensor, where you can basically see the high and low temperature as well as the current temperature. Now there's some different ways to get to this. The most easy way, I've got some videos out there that show you how to add it to your widgets. And that's what I'm gonna do here. So I'm just gonna press the ABC button and I've got it set as my very first widget. So you'll see 92 is the high in the last 4 hours and 71 is the low in the last 4 hours, which is really way off. The one thing I'll say about the temperature widget, and this is where a lot of people don't like it, is you get some really invalid readings because of the fact that it's sitting on your wrist. So for example, right now it's saying that the temperature is 71, which is pretty accurate in here. I've got a thermometer sitting right here next to me, and the actual temperature is 66. So it's really pretty close, but it's a little bit off because of my, again, because of the heat from your wrist. If you want to get an accurate reading on the temperature sensor, the best thing to do is to take the watch off and let it sit and start reading the temperature without being on your wrist. And I'm going to do that now. It's fairly cold outside, so let's go outside, take the watch off my wrist, and let's see what happens to the temperature. Okay, so as I mentioned, I'm now outside, and let's see if the temperature drops. Now, I've got it on my wrist. I'm going to take it off. Now, the one thing I'll say on this is you should start seeing it adjust pretty much immediately. Let's see, how can I set it where you guys can see it? Because the watch updates in real time, we should see an adjustment fairly quick. If you've got the watch in battery saver mode and you've got your screen display set to adjust, every minute you'll see you won't see as quite of an update, as quick as an update as if you don't. If you're just wearing the watch in non-battery saver mode, you should see it update pretty much immediately. And you can see the temperature is dropping. Everything I've read basically says if you want to get a temperature reading, take it off your wrist, sit it outside or sit it down wherever you want to get the reading, wait about 5 minutes and you should be accurate. So that's what we're going to do now. I'm going to pause this video. Maybe I'll let it run a few more seconds so you can see it drop. And then we'll come back in 5 minutes and we'll take a look at what the reading is out here. So I'm gonna pause this, we'll come back in 5 minutes and we'll take a look at what the temperature shows. Okay, so I'm back and it's been exactly 5 minutes. The temperature has dropped down to 48 degrees. I was reading on the Garmin website, it actually recommends 20 to 30 minutes is what you would want to take the watch off, let it sit for 20 to 30 minutes to get an accurate reading. And I'll say that seems to be about right. After 5 minutes, it dropped down to 48. According to my cell phone and my thermometer, which is outside, it should get to about 38, 39 degrees.
and then it should stop and we should have an accurate temperature reading. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to come back and we'll revisit it after the 20 minute recommendation that Garmin says, and we'll see what the temperature shows. Okay, everybody, so it's been 15 minutes exactly. I was going to wait 20 to 30 like the recommended on Garmin site, but 15 minutes after taking it off of my wrist from coming in from coming outside from inside, my temperature reading is accurate. It's 38 degrees out here, and that matches what my cell phone says, and that matches what my outdoor thermometer says as well. So if you want to get an accurate temperature reading, this watch works extremely well. Just remember, take it off your wrist, let it sit for a while so that you're not getting any heat from your wrist to skew the numbers, and you'll get an accurate temperature reading.
So what exactly is the My Day widget? Well, first let's talk about what's on my watch face. If you're using activity tracking, you're gonna wanna look at certain values. Maybe you're interested in how many steps you get, or intensity minutes, or floors climbed. I'm showing those as data elements on my watch face. I've got my steps on here, I've got my floors climbed for the day, and I've got my calories for the day. And that's fine, but those three things are taking up elements on my watch face that maybe I wanna see those, but I don't wanna be using them as elements on my watch face. Well, I've got a couple different options. I could go install individual widgets for each of those. So for example, here's my intensity minutes. That's a widget. Here's my steps for the day. That's another widget. Here's my floors climbed. That's another widget. So the good thing about the widget is it'll give you some details. So for example, floors climbed is showing me I've got 1 out of my goal of 10. And the steps is showing me I've got 1,695 out of my goal of 10,000. If you don't care about that stuff, you can install what's called the My Day widget. Let's go ahead and do that now. I'm gonna press the menu button. I'm gonna go down to settings. I'm gonna go to widgets, and I'm going to add a widget. And the one that you're looking for is this calendar icon, and it says My Day. What's funny is the first time I came across this widget, I thought it was gonna pull in my calendar meetings and stuff like that from Outlook or from Gmail or something like that. It has nothing to do with your external calendars. It's just an activity calendar for that day. So let's go ahead and add it. And then we'll go back to the main watch face and we'll take a look at it. All the My Day widget does is give a high-level summary of your activities for that day. Timed activities, intensity minutes, floors climbed, steps, calories burned, etc. You can see in my case, we're seeing the same information we saw from my watch face. We're just seeing it in one widget versus using data elements or versus using individual widgets. When you're in the widget, if you press the GPS button, you'll see that it highlights and it gives you this down arrow. I can press the down arrow to see if there's anything else to be displayed. In my case, because I haven't done any intensity minutes or trainings or anything like that for the day, there's nothing else to show. That's a quick look at the My Day widget. Once you're done, you can press the back button. The good thing about it is it kind of gives you a summary view of your activities for the day. The negative about it is it doesn't show you everything that you're going to see in the Garmin Connect app. So for example, I can't see my sleep for the day. I can't see my hydration for the day. Things like that that you can control on the app, you can't control on the watch. But it is pretty good if you are like me, where you're kind of interested in your activity tracking for the day, but you don't want to have to go through each individual widget to see it or use a data element on your watch face. So the music controls widget is exactly what it says. It is a controller for your cell phone's music. A lot of questions that I get on this channel deal with whether or not you can put music on your Garmin Instinct. Can you go for a walk, listen to music without taking your cell phone? Unfortunately, with the Garmin Instinct, there's no way to do that. You would need to get a watch like the Phoenix or some of the other Garmin models that have storage for music files on the device. What the Garmin Instinct allows you to do is it allows you to basically control the music of your cell phone. I like to think of it in terms of if you've got stereo controls or Bluetooth controls in your car, where you play your MP3s from your phone, and then on your steering wheel, you sit there and move to the next song or previous song or pause. That's basically what your Garmin Instinct's gonna do. So enough about that, let's jump to it and let's download the widget. Now I'm gonna go through this pretty quick. If you don't know how to download widgets, I've done a video in the past that walks you through the basics of it. You might wanna review that. But in this case, you're looking for a widget called Music Controls. It's got an icon of a music note here. I've added the widget, and then let's go back to the main screen and jump into it and see what it does. Now you'll notice I press the down button to go into the widget, and right away the song's already playing. It's showing the name of the song and the artist of the song.
First, let me say I've got a couple songs on my phone for video purposes only. If you know any of these songs, kudos to you, because I kind of went deep in my music library to find some stuff that I didn't think anybody would even know out there. So what we're seeing here is you're seeing the last song that was played on my cell phone being displayed on the watch. I can press GPS to go into it, and you'll notice I've got a couple different options. I can use the up or down button to circle through all of these. The top one is volume. We'll do that one in a second. This would be play or pause. This would be to go to the next song. This would be to go to the previous song. So let's go ahead and just hit play. You'll notice it says playing. And again, it shows the song, the artist, and then the number of seconds that we are into the song. I can hit pause. I can resume. I can choose the volume, turn it down, turn it up. We can go back. We can go to the next song. We can go back to the previous song. And actually, just like any radio, if I click this button and I'm in a song, it takes me back to the beginning of the song. So if I press it once, it takes me to the beginning of the song. If I press it twice, it takes me to the previous song. And then we can pause. The one thing I'll say is when you're out doing your exercise, so I'm going to go ahead and get to a song, and let's play this one. So I've got the song I want, and now I want to look at my exercise. You don't have to stay in this widget. You can press the back button to go to the song. I can press the back button to go to the main screen, or I can go to my activity. My song will keep playing in the background. But if I want to adjust the song, I need to go back into the widget. And that's basically all it does. Now, I'm playing some MP3s right here. Let me pause those. Another question I get is, well, will it work with SiriusXM or Spotify? It will work with anything you've got installed on your phone. The caveat is you have to start the music on your phone first, because it's only going to be using the last music that's been played on your phone. So, for example, in my case, I was listening to MP3s. That's what my Garmin device picked up. If I want to go listen to SiriusXM, I can do that, but I need to go on my phone, go into SiriusXM. Remember, we're seeing my MP3 here. I'm going to go into SiriusXM, though, and I'm going to hit play. Now, all of a sudden, it went to what's playing in SiriusXM. You'll notice it's Paul Young, First Wave, same thing. I can still pause. I can still adjust the volume, just like with my MP3s. I can go to the next song only if the music that I'm listening to on my cell phone allows for a next song. You can also see that it'll display some information. So I'm listening to First Wave Deep Cuts from SiriusXM. Shows me the channel, shows me the artist, it shows me the song. And then once you're done, as always, you can press back and go to the main screen. But that's a quick look at how the Music Controls widget works. So the stress widget basically displays your current level of stress, and it also gives a graph of your stress level over a period of the last 2.5 hours. I'm going to show it to you. It's kind of like the pulse oximeter in that you can't really display it as a data element. It's only available as a widget. So we're going to go in first and foremost and add it as a widget. Now, I've done a video in the past that walks you through adding widgets. On my watch, if I press the up or down button, you notice that nothing happens. I don't have any widgets installed. I thought it might be simpler just to put it as the only widget. So I'm going to go down to settings. I'm going to go down to widgets. I'm going to add a widget. And the one that we're looking for is this guy right here, stress. So I've added the widget. And now let's go run it. And it kind of works the same way as the heart rate monitor, the pulse oximeter. When you go into it, all it does is it displays your current level of stress. You can see mine, it's pretty high. It went from 94 to 93. And that's it. You can basically look at that. If you press the GPS button, it'll say, take a moment to relax. You can either do this or not. I'm gonna not do it first just to show you what happens. Here's what I was saying. Here's the graph of my stress level over the last 2.5 hours. I can press the down button and I can get to my relax timer, or we can do it back this way. I'll just press GPS, and when it says, do you wanna take a moment to relax? You can press yes, and it'll take you to your relax timer as well. You can set your relax timer in the number of minutes you want. I'm just going to do 1 minute just to show you. And when you select it, it's going to basically give you a breathing exercise to sit and breathe, relax a little bit to try and get your stress level down. Now, I'm not going to bore you with it, but basically when it finishes this relaxation timer, it'll just go back and show you your current stress level just like before. At any point you want to, you can stop the relax timer by just pressing the back button. I'm gonna let you look at it a little bit longer and then I'll do that. Anyway, that's long enough, I think. And we're back at our main stress screen. Once you've used the widget to determine your stress level, you can just press the back button to get back to your main screen. So first, let me say, I'm doing this video, I am an Apple iOS user. So everything you're seeing in here is going to be shown with my Apple phone. It should work about the same with regards to the Android phone, but I've never used an Android phone with this watch. So just know that as you're watching the video. The other thing I'll say is you don't have to install the notifications widget in order to get notifications on your Garmin Instinct watch. I'm gonna try and explain that to you, show you some examples in the video. So let's jump into it. I'm kind of assuming you know some basic information about the Garmin Instinct watch, what data elements are, what widgets are. If you don't know those things, you might wanna go back through some of my earlier videos and familiarize yourself with that, because I'm gonna be going through it kind of quick. Let's take a look at the data element I've got up here. It's my sunrise sunset. Let's change that. I'm gonna press and hold the menu button. I'm gonna choose watch face. I'm going to keep this one, but I'm going to customize it. One of the data element options that you have, we'll go ahead and save all these, is this little three-dot icon, which basically looks like a little notification cloud or bubble. You can see that I've got 8 notifications from my Apple phone that haven't been cleared from the notification center. Now, in this video, I'm not going to be showing you how to control what notifications you get. I've done another video for that in the past. All I'm going to be showing you is how to see the notifications on your Garmin Instinct watch. As with everything on the watch, a data element will show you basic information. A widget will show you more details about that information. So I can see here that I've got 8 notifications that I missed, but I can't do anything from the data element. I can't get to the notifications to see them. I can't clear them. I can't do anything other than see that I've got them. The other thing I can do without having the widget on my watch is I can receive notifications. So as you see, I just sent myself a test email, came through on my watch, got an email. I can see some basic information on the notification on my watch. Question about in dot, dot, dot. You can't see anything else. Now, if I'm on my watch, I can press the GPS button to read more about that notification. But if I'm not on my watch, after the notification timeout, that notification is going to be gone. We should be seeing that here in a second. My notification timeout is set for 30 seconds. So after 30 seconds of not doing anything, boom, the notification's gone. But you can see that the data element up here is now at 9, showing me that I missed another notification. So what if we want to see the notifications? What if we want to get back to a prior notification? We need to install the notification widget. And to do that, we're going to do it just like any other widget. We're going to press and hold the menu button. We're going to arrow down to settings. We're going to press GPS for settings. We're going to arrow down to widgets, press GPS, add widget, and we are going to be looking for the notifications widget. The icon is going to be the same as what we saw in the data element. We're going to press GPS to add it, and we've successfully added the notifications widget. Now when we go back to the main watch face,
we can still see that we missed 9 notifications, but if we go to the widget, we can actually see the notifications that we've missed. If I press GPS, I can get into those notifications and I can use the up or down button to go through each of them and look at what they are. So once I'm on a notification that I want to see, I'm going to click the GPS button to select it. And then I can either press the down button to clear it, or while I'm on it, I can press GPS to go into that notification and read more about it. So I can see here that I got a question about the Instinct, and it looks like here's the text of the email. Do you think the Garmin Instinct watch is better than the Phoenix or Casio Pro Trek? Now, with an Apple device, I can't respond to this text message. All I can do is read it. I'm pretty sure it's the same with Android, but I'm not sure. With Apple, unfortunately, they have it to where the only thing you can really respond to a text with is the Apple Watch. But unfortunately, they kind of block it from any other smartwatch. That's how I can read the notification. I can press back to get back to the notification and then get back to my main notification screens. If I want to clear that, I can press GPS to select it, press the down arrow to clear it, and it will clear it and it will take me to my next notification. Now, if it's a phone notification that I've missed, you can see here that I missed a phone call. This is a spam call that I got, so if anybody's watching this video, I wouldn't worry about calling this number back. But I can press the GPS button to see what it was. I can press back, and I've also got some options with the phone call. If I press down, I can actually call the number back. Now, it's not going to dial it from my watch. All the watch is going to do is make my phone call back the number. I can also delete the notification, or I can leave the notification there and just press back to get back to my notifications. While I'm in the notifications widget, I can also press and hold the menu button to get to my notification options. If I press GPS, I can go into my notification options. For example, my status, do I want it during activity? Now I'm gonna breeze through these. I've done a video in the past where I'll walk you through notification options. I can adjust my timeout. And then again, I can press back. I can remove the widget if I want to, or I can go back to the notification listing. Once you're done reviewing your notifications, you can click back. Now again, I've still got 8 of them there. Ideally, I think the way most people would do it is you would go into the widget, look at your notifications that are there, review them, and then clear out the ones that you want to where you get back to where you don't have any notifications. And whenever you get a new one, you know that you've got a new notification. So the calories widget is something that you can download just to basically track how many calories you're burning throughout the day, either through activity or through resting. If you look at my watch face, you'll notice that I've got calories displayed up here in the little circular data element. I've currently burned 1,232 calories a day. But as with other things on this watch, maybe I want to get more information about those calories being burned. In order to do that, I can download the widget for the calories. And that's what we're going to do now. Now I'm going to press the up or down button and you'll notice nothing happens. That's because I don't have any widgets currently installed on my watch. We're going to go and we're going to download it. I'm going to press and hold the menu button. I'm going to arrow down to settings. I'm going to arrow down to widgets. I'm going to do add widgets. And then you're going to be looking for one that's labeled calories. The icon is a flame, just like what we saw in the data element. I'll press the GPS button, and I've successfully added that widget. Now I can go back to my main watch face, press either the up or down button. It's the only widget I've got, so it's going to go to it. What the widget does is it shows the same information we saw before. I'm now at 1,235 calories burned, but it also gives a breakdown between how many of those were from resting and how many of those were from while I was being active and moving. The other thing is I can press the GPS button and I can see a historical trend over the last 7 days of my average active and resting calories. You can see right here, this is my breakdown for the given day. So if you add those two numbers together, it's gonna equal the number 1235. But this gives the breakdown of my current day, how many active calories, how many resting calories, and then I can look at how that's comparing to my average over the last 7 days. That's really about all you can do with the widget. As always, the data element on the watch face is going to show you the least amount of information. The widget will show you a little bit more. If you want even more than that, you need to go to the Garmin Connect website or Garmin Connect app. So the first thing is know that this is the calendar widget. This isn't the training calendar. There is a difference between the two. All this widget really does is it displays your calendar events from your phone that you have coming up, your most recent or your most current events that are next on your calendar. It's kind of like the weather widget. It's not going to do anything on its own. It has to have a phone connection to read the latest information, and all it's doing is displaying it on the watch. So let's jump to it. If you look in my watch, I'm pressing the up and down button. That's an indication that there's no widgets currently installed on my watch. I'm gonna go through it pretty quick and install the widget. If you don't know how to install widgets, I've done videos in the past that walk you through adding widgets and customizing your widgets. It's pretty easy. We're gonna go down to widgets. We're gonna do add widgets, and you're gonna see all of your widget options in here. The calendar widget is gonna be labeled calendar, and it's gonna have an icon that looks like this. You don't wanna confuse it with my day, because I read it kind of as my day is kind of the same way. It's got kind of a calendar icon, and it's showing you, hey, my day, what's coming up for this day? They're two totally different widgets. I have done a video in the past on my day, but the one we're talking about is calendar. So I'm gonna add the calendar widget, and then let's go take a look at what it does. And again, there's not a whole lot to show you here. When you go to it, all it's gonna do is first it's gonna give you a summary view of the next events you have coming up. So my next event is Lunch with John. If I wanna get more details about that, I can press GPS. The three dots down there shows you that if you press GPS, you can get more details. Now I can actually see an expanded view of my events that are coming up. So again, Lunch with John, Water the Garden, and then this event, if you notice, these two are for Monday the 12th. This next event down here is for Tuesday the 13th. So those are the next events I have coming up, both for today as well as tomorrow. I can't go any further, though, than tomorrow. On any one of these events, though, I can press GPS to see as many details as I can about the given event. And then I can press the back button. And again, press GPS to see more details. It's unlike the cell phone in that the cell phone, I can go as far into the future as I want to, or in the past to look at events. All this does is bring up the next events you have coming up, and it stops after a certain limitation, and then you can't go any further than that. It's kind of like just a quick glance at, hey, what do I have going on today for the rest of the day? Once you're done with the widget, you can just press the back button until you're back to your main screen. I want to go look at my most recent activities. All I have to do from the main watch face is press and hold the menu button, go down to history, press GPS to select history, and then select activities. And you can see, here's all of my most recent activities, starting with the most recent, going to the most earliest. On any one of these, let's look for example. This one is 1.3 miles. It was yesterday at 6:58. I can press GPS on any one of them, and I can get into different things like the details, the number of laps, the map of the activity, my time and heart rate zone, elevation plotter, I can delete the activity. So that wasn't too bad. We went, what, three keystrokes to get there? We went menu, history, activities. What the last sport widget does is it basically gives you a quick connect to your last activity. I'll show you how to do that. As with any activity, or I'm sorry, any widget, we need to go download the widget. So we're gonna go to settings, widgets, add widget, and the one that you're looking for is called the last sport. Icon looks like a guy with his arms out. We'll press GPS to select it. I kind of wish they would have called it last activity versus last sport. I don't really think of the Garmin as tracking sports. I think of it as tracking more so exercises or activities. Now that we've got the widget installed, instead of going like we just did to go look at my most recent activities, we can just go straight to the widget, and it takes us directly into our last activity. Same thing we saw before. It was a walking activity, 1.3 miles, the pace, the time. I can also press the GPS button while I'm in the activity, and I can get to the same screen we saw earlier, all of my activities. I can go to any one of these, can press the GPS, and I can see the same thing as before. Details, the number of laps, the map, assuming you had the GPS on, my time and heart rate zone, the elevation plot, basically the change of altitude during the activity, or I can delete the activity. Last Sport is a little bit different than some of the other ones because it doesn't care what the activity was. If it was the hunting activity, fishing activity, any of them, it's going to take you directly into your last one. But again, you can press the GPS button to go to any activity regardless of what it was. I hope that makes sense, at least gives you a glimpse of what the Last Sport widget is. So if you've watched my video before, this widget is very similar to the Last Sport widget. If you want to go look at your running activities, you don't need the widget. Let's go ahead and do that now. I'm going to go ahead and press the menu button. I'm going to go down to history. I'm going to press GPS to select history, and then I'm going to select my activities. If I want to see my runs, all I have to do is go through all of my recent activities. But you're going to see my last activity was a walk. Then there's a run. There's another run. But there's a walk. And so on and so forth, and I have to keep cycling through all of these until I can find all of my runs. Well, Garmin gives you a way to get to your runs without having to go through all of your activities and find your runs, and that's the Last Run widget. We're gonna go ahead and install that, take a look at it. As with any other widget, you have to install it first, so we're gonna press and hold the menu button, we're gonna go down to settings, press GPS to select settings, go down to widgets, press GPS to select widgets, and then we're gonna add widgets. The one that we're looking for is Last Run, and you'll notice that the icon is the same as the icon for the running activity. We're gonna press GPS to select it. We successfully added the widget. Basically, what this widget does, I kind of think of it as in terms of like Excel, Microsoft Excel. You've got an Excel document, you put a filter on it just so you can see certain values. This widget does the same thing. Let's go into it. The first thing it's gonna do is it's gonna show you a summary of the week of your running activities. So you can see for this week, I've run a little over a half a mile. There's my distance, there's my pace. I can press GPS to see the individual runs, but like I was talking about in Excel, now when I go through all of these, I'm not seeing any other activities other than runs. Now you'll notice that this one here is a treadmill run. Run would be the running activity, treadmill run, trail run, any kind of running activity, they're all gonna be filtered in this one widget. If you want to see the details of any of your runs, you can go to it, press the GPS. You can see that this run was yesterday at 5:19 p.m. You can click on GPS to see the details of the run, the distance, the time, the pace, calories, average heart rate, max heart rate. This is the same information we would see if we just went and looked at it on our activities page. The laps, if you had your GPS on, you'd be able to see the map for the activity, time and heart rate zones. Your elevation plot, basically the altitude changes during the activity. And then I can delete the activity. Once you're done, you can simply press back to go to your main screen. It's very similar to the Last Sport widget, but Last Sport takes you to all of your activities. Last Run is gonna take you just to your running activities that you've got saved on your Garmin Instinct watch. But the widget we're talking about here is workout intensity. Basically, every week, the World Health Organization recommends that you get 150 minutes of moderate exercise or 75 minutes of vigorous exercise. So moderate exercise would be something like going for a walk every day, a light jog, whereas vigorous exercise is going to be more like a run. And the Garmin Instinct allows you to track whether or not you're getting those minutes every week or not. And I'm going to show you how we can look at that. So as with most things on this watch, the most basic way you can look at your intensity minutes is by adding it as a data field on your watch face. Not every item out there is available as a data field, but the intensity minutes is. So let's go ahead and add that. I'm gonna press and hold the menu button. I'm gonna choose watch face. I'm just gonna keep this watch face, but I'm gonna customize it. And the data field that you're looking for is this one here. I guess that's a clock that's moving. I always think it looks like a time bomb. But that's the data element that we're going to choose. I'm going to go through and accept all the other ones. And I can see by looking at my watch face that I've had 119 intensity minutes this week out of the 150 that I'm supposed to get. So that's great. But like with most things on the watch, if I want to get more details about the item, I can go download the intensity widget and I can see more information than just the data element on the watch face. So let's go ahead and get the widget. I'm going to press and hold the menu button. Go down to settings. Let's choose widgets. I'm going to add the widget. And again, we're looking for the icon that's the clock that's moving. It's labeled intensity minutes. I've successfully added it. And now let's press back
go to our main watch face and let's check out what the widget does. So remember, 119 is what I've got. The widget's showing you the exact same for the week. I've hit 119 minutes out of the 150 that I'm supposed to get. There's also a little graph that's going around here that shows how close I am to hitting my 150 goal. It's basically just a bar graph to show you what's going on. I can also press GPS while I'm on the widget, and I can see more details. So for example, I need 31 more minutes of moderate exercise or 16 more minutes of vigorous exercise this week to hit my goal. You'll see the down arrow. I can also press down to get more details. I can get a weekly breakdown of where have I gotten my intensity minutes. You'll notice Monday, Tuesday, every day of this week, I haven't gotten any minutes, but Wednesday, I got 119 of the 150 minutes I'm supposed to get. That's basically everything that the widget shows you. I can press up to go back to the top page, or I can press the back button, go back to my home screen to get out of the widget. That's a quick look at how to look at the intensity minutes on your Garmin Instinct watch. As with everything else, if you want to get more details, you can go to the Garmin Connect app or website.
So there's a widget on the watch called ABC, which is for your altimeter, barometer, and compass. Just a couple basic things. There's three buttons here on the left-hand side. There's two buttons here on the right-hand side. Most of them are going to come into play for this feature, but they're all pretty easy and they're pretty standard as far as throughout the watch. If you want to go in and view either of these things, your altimeter, barometer, or compass, the quickest way is you've got an ABC button down here, and that's what it stands for. All you're going to do is you're going to press and hold it, and that'll take you into this widget. And you can see I'm in the compass setting right now. So if you just want to look at your compass, you can just leave it on this. But if you're wanting to navigate to the barometer altimeter, you would just use either the up button, which is your menu button, or the down button, which is your ABC button, and you can navigate through the different features. So your altimeter and your barometer. The other thing that's kind of important is each one of these have their own settings that you can get to by pressing the GPS button. So for example, for the barometer, since we're on it, I can sit here and view the information, or I can press the GPS button and I can go in and see what my settings are for a barometer. So I can calibrate it, I can plot, can turn on or off the storm alert, and so on and so forth. Change the way the pressure's measured or displayed. And down here at the bottom right, you've got your set button, which is always gonna be your back button. So that takes you back. But again, as you're adjusting through these things, you can always press the GPS button to go in and see if there's any options that you can change. Just press the back and it takes you back to the screen. And then once you're done with the ABC feature completely, you want to get back to your watch face. You just press the back button. So it's very easy. Again, just press and hold the ABC button. Use the up or down to navigate through to whatever you're trying to see. Use the GPS button if you need to adjust any settings or do any calibrations. And then use the back button to get back to the main screen.
And to navigate through your different widgets, you can simply just press the up or down button to go through them. So for example, this one's the barometric pressure, here's the compass, sunrise and sunset. A lot of times when you get to the weather one, it's going to look like this, or if you use the watch the way I do, it's going to say waiting for data. So the weather widget on this watch, the watch doesn't really predict weather. It actually uses your cell phone weather app to display the weather information. And open Garmin Connect and wait for it to start connecting. And you'll see as soon as it connected, now all of a sudden you're able to see the weather information. So you've got your high temperature, your low temperature, your wind 6 miles per hour out of the northeast, your humidity, and then what the skies look like. It's partly cloudy today. As with any of the widgets, when you're in there, you can actually press the GPS button to see if there's any settings or configurations. When I press it here, it'll take me to the hourly forecast. So it's showing me today per hour. I'm basically looking at for the next 4 hours. That's the weather. If I press the down button, you get to the daily forecast. So for the next 4 days, that's what the weather looks like. And that's really going to be the only features that you've got in there. If I press it down or up again, all I can do is go back to hourly or daily, and that's it. Once you're done viewing the weather, just like with anything, you'll press the set button
to go back, and you're back on your default screen. The next thing you need to do, if you're really interested in the moon data, is you need to add it as an available widget on your watch. Now, I've done a video to show you how to add widgets. To get to your widgets, you're just gonna press the menu or ABC button to go up or down. And you'll wanna make sure you've got the moon phase set as a widget, because just like with any other widget, you can get more data from it than you can from your watch face. Now we're in the moon widget, and what it shows you is the current date, what the moon looks like, the moon rise time, the moon set time, and that it's a waxing crescent moon, which I think is pretty cool. The other thing is, when you're in this widget, if you press the GPS button, you can change the date by going using the ABC or menu button to go backwards or forwards. So if I want to see what's the moon going to look like on Christmas Day, I can go here and I can see it. The moon's going to look like that. Moonrise is going to be at 2:30 p.m. Moonset's going to be at 3:12 a.m. And then there's the status of the moon. So I think that's kind of a cool feature to be able to change the dates and see what's the moon going to look like, especially if you're a hunter or something like that, and you want to know, hey, I'm going to be hunting in 2 weeks, what's the moon going to be like? I think it's a pretty neat feature. As always, when you're done with it, press the back button twice to get back to your main screen, and now you're back on your time display. Let's go into the other way you can view sunrise and sunset information, and that's by using the sunrise and sunset widget. So just like any other widget, we're going to press and hold the menu button. We're going to arrow down to settings, and we're going to arrow down to widgets. And you'll want to look through your list. I currently do not have it set as a widget. You might already have it set. But if not, if you go to the very bottom, you can do add widget. And then if you go towards the bottom, you should see sunrise and sunset. There it is. Select GPS. Now we've added that widget. Now we can press our back button to get back to our home screen. And just like any other widget, we can press the up or down menu to see our widgets. Because it's the last one we added, if we press up, that'll take us to our most recent widget. And there's the sunrise and sunset data widget for the Garmin Instinct. As with other widgets, the widget is going to have more information than the data element. So you'll notice with the widget, I can see today's date. I can see the position of the sun over the horizon currently. Again, it's almost 1 o'clock, so it's just past midday. Sunrise time, sunset time. I can also see twilight time for the morning and for the evening. The other thing I can do is, while I'm on this widget, if I press the GPS button, I can adjust and go to different days of the week. So if I wanted to go back to January 1st and see what the sunrise and sunset and twilight times were, I can. Or maybe I'm going deer hunting or going to go stargazing or something like that in the future. I can go to any date in the future and see what the sunrise and sunset data is for that date. So I hope that makes sense. It's not that complicated, but as always, if you've got any questions, feel free to ask them. One thing I'll say is, once you're done with the widget, if you press the set button, you can get back to your main screen. You press and hold the menu button, and then arrow down to settings, press GPS to go to settings, and then go to widgets and press GPS. What we're going to do is, we can press the up button to go to the very bottom of our list, and we're going to do add widgets. And now we're going to arrow all the way down through all of our widgets until we see alternate time zone. It should look like a map. There we go. Once we're on that, we're going to press the GPS button, and now we've added that widget. So now we can go back to our main screen. Now, if we press the up or down button, one of the widgets we should see is alternate time zones. It's going to be at the bottom of my list because it's the last one that I've added. Ah, there it is. You'll notice that there's a little plus mark because I don't have any added. I'm going to press the GPS button to add a time zone. Again, it says add. I'll press the GPS button again. Now I can go through and I can add any other time zone that I'm interested in checking. So just for the sake of this video, I'm going to put in Bangkok. Press the GPS button to select it. Do you want to rename it? Yes or no? So I could rename it, or I could just take the default. I'm going to say, I'm going to do no on this. If you want to see what it looks like with renaming, you basically have to use this to, you know, backspace and then choose your alphabet characters. I'm not going to do that. I'm just going to press the back button. I'm going to say I don't need to rename it. But now I can successfully see Bangkok's time zone. If I want to add another one, I'm just going to go down and do add. And let's put in Alaska just for the sake of quickness. Do I want to rename it? No. So now I have Bangkok and Alaska time zones as part of my widget. And then we can go back. And now we've successfully added alternate time zones to our Garmin Instinct watch. And then what's nice is it's already part of the settings of that widget. So if I want to see those time zones, all I have to do is press the up button to go into that widget. There's the time zones for a quick glance at the time in those different regions. And today I'm going to be talking to you about step tracking. As with all the features on the Garmin Instinct watch, the most basic way to get the element that you're looking for is to add it as a data element on your watch face. And I'm going to do that now. Now, some of these things I'm going through really quick. I assume you know how to customize your watch face. I assume you know how to add a widget. If you don't, again, I've done videos in the past that are more basic to walk you through how to do that stuff. But I'm going to go pretty quick here. We're going to press and hold the menu button. We're going to press GPS to select watch face. We're going to press GPS again to select that one. And then we're going to press GPS again to customize it. You'll notice that the data element starts blinking. So I'm going to go ahead and cycle through and add the step tracking as a data element. We're looking for an icon that has 2 feet on it, and that's your step tracking. I currently have 1,545 steps. I want to add that as a data element to my watch face, so I'm going to press GPS. And I'm going to press GPS a couple more times to save my watch face. Now we've successfully added our steps to our watch face. As I walk throughout the day, I'll see my steps increase. That's the most basic way to see the steps on your Garmin Instinct. As with other things, if you want to see more details, we can also add the step widget, and that's going to give us a little bit more detail. So let's go ahead and do that now. I'm going to press and hold the menu button again. This time I'm going to arrow down to settings, press GPS to select settings. I'm going to arrow down to widgets, press GPS to select widgets. I'll see all of the widgets I currently have installed. If I go to the very bottom, I can do add widgets. And then I'm going to arrow through until I see the same 2 feet icon that we saw earlier. For me, it looks like it's at the bottom of my list. Steps, I'm going to press GPS to select it. Now we've successfully added the step widget. Let's go ahead and go back to our main screen. As always, if you press the up button, it'll take you to your most recently added widget. So now we're looking at the step widget. Same icon, same information, 1,545 is my current steps, but we can also see what my daily goal is. For today, I'm supposed to get 6,850 steps, and then we can see this progress bar that's going around to show me how close I am to hitting my goal. I can also press the GPS button to see some more detail regarding my steps. Same thing, my daily steps, my daily goal, but I can look for the last 7 days and see how many steps I've gotten for the last 7 days. So you can see today I'm pretty low. Yesterday I was pretty low. Wednesday I had a pretty decent day. I can also click the down button to see the distance that I've traveled. So for today I've traveled 0.8 miles. And then again, I can see it for the last 7 days. So that's a quick look at how to see it on your step widget. Once we're done, we just press the back button to go to the main screen. The floors climbed tracking. So as with most things on the Garmin Instinct watch, there's a couple different ways you can go about seeing how many floors you've climbed. First is you can add it as a data element on your watch face. And I've done some videos to kind of slowly walk you through that. I'm going to do that really quick here. We're just going to press the menu button. I'm going to choose watch face. I'm going to choose my current one and I'm going to customize it. Where my moon phase is, I'm just going to change that one. And as I go through the different settings, you're going to see one that looks like a flight of stairs. Here we go. That's the number of floors I've climbed today. If I want to leave that on my watch face, all I have to do is press GPS, confirm it, and I can track it that way by seeing it as a data element. As always, the data element is going to show you the least amount of data. It's just a quick reference point that you can always see to see the given data element. The other way you can see the floors climbed is you can add it as a widget. And again, I've done videos on how to add widgets. I'm going to do this really quick. We can press and hold the menu button. Go down to settings. We can choose widgets. I'm going to add a widget, and I'm going to look for that same icon or you can look for Floors Climbed, I believe is the name of it. There we go, all the way at the bottom. For me, Floors Climbed. I'm gonna press GPS to select it. Now I've added that widget. We can go back. And as with all widgets, we can press the up or down button. Up should always go to your last widget. And now we can see the widget. You'll notice on the widget, you can see more details than the data element on your screen. I can see that I've climbed one floor today. I can also see that 10 underneath it, which is my daily goal. So my daily goal is 10 flights of floors to climb. I've successfully done one. You can see the progress bar is gradually going around. The more floors I go up, the more it'll go around. The other thing with the widget is I can press the GPS button while I'm on the widget, and I can see a historical trend over the last 7 days of how many floors I've climbed. So the widget's always going to give you more detail than the data element. That's another way you can look at it. I should mention that if I go back and I look at it, you have to have activity tracking turned on your watch in order for it to record the floors that you've climbed, just like steps or anything else. The other thing is it uses your barometer to determine whether or not you've climbed floors. So each floor is equivalent to about 3 meters or 10 feet. So sometimes people say, it's not adjusting, it's not calculating it right. That's how it's calculating it, is it's using your barometer. So about 10 feet equals one floor. Once you're done with this screen, you can go back. And we've successfully looked at how we can look at the number of floors climbed. And there's a couple of different ways you can view your heart rate information. One of them, if you've watched my other videos, if you know the basics of the Garmin Instinct, is you can add it as a data element on your watch face. Now, I don't currently have it on there. I'll walk through it real quick just to add it. I'm gonna press and hold the menu button. I'm gonna press GPS to select watch face. I'm gonna stay on this one and I'm gonna select customize. And I'm just gonna put it up here. These are your different data element screens. You can really put it in multiple places. For me, I like it there. I'm gonna go ahead and select it. And I'm gonna finish out the screen. And now I've successfully added the heart rate, a monitor. You'll notice that there's two lines because there's no heart rate. It's because it's not on my wrist. So I'm gonna go ahead and do that now. Obviously, in order to get the heart rate information, you're gonna need to have it on your wrist. So bear with me a second. A couple of things about the heart rate. When you're wearing the watch, you want to have it nice and snug. You don't want the watch moving at all when you're doing any kind of exercises or walking around. The other thing is you want to have it above your wrist bone here. And you don't want to be wearing any kind of sunscreen, insect repellent, lotion, anything like that under the watch. You want to keep the sensor on the bottom of the watch as clean as possible to get an accurate reading. You'll notice after I put the watch on, you can now see my heart rate. I'm currently at 79 beats per minute. So that's the first way you can view your heart rate information. The other way, as with everything on this watch, there's usually a widget for it. So the data screen is just going to show you the basics. If you want to see more information, you can add it to your widget loop. Now, I've got a video out there that shows you how to add things to your widget loop. So if you don't have it in there, you might want to watch that video and see how you can add it. But I've already got it, so I'm going to press the up or down button to get to my widgets. And there's the heart rate widget. Again, it'll show you your current heart rate, but it'll also show you your high and low heart rate for the last 4 hours, as well as a trend graph over the last 4 hours. While I'm in the widget, if I want to see more information, I can press the GPS button and I can see my last 7 day trend. So my average heart rate over the last 7 days has been 57 beats per minute. And then you can see the trend over the days. Also, while you're in the widget, or press the back button to get back to it. If you hold down the menu button, you can get your heart rate options. So I'm gonna go ahead and select that. If you wanna turn off the heart rate completely so that you're not tracking it at all, on the status, you can just toggle by pressing the GPS button, but you'll notice you're gonna get this message that it's gonna cut off the heart rate, body battery, stress, and other features. So I'm not gonna do that. But if you did wanna turn off your heart rate feature, that's how you would do it. You also have the ability to say, do you want the heart rate being tracked while you're swimming? Yes or no. You can also set alerts. Do you want abnormal heart rate alerts? If you select this, you'll see that you can set alert. If your heart rate gets abnormally high, you can get an alert on your watch. You can also set an alert if your heart rate gets abnormally low. So that's kind of a cool feature, especially if you're somebody who's really into health, or maybe you're having heart issues, or maybe you've got stress issues you're supposed to be keeping an eye on. I think that's a pretty neat feature. Last but not least, you can do broadcast. Now you'll notice I'm gonna go ahead and start broadcasting my heart rate. You really don't need to do this unless you've got another Garmin device that you're trying to send your heart rate information from your Garmin Instinct over to it. But I just want to show you what it's doing. You'll notice that there's a heart here and it's showing a little broadcast signal. That lets me know that it's broadcasting my heart rate. Once you're done, you can press any button to get out of that. Again, unless you've got another device that you're trying to send it to, you really wouldn't need that feature. And then you can choose whether or not to broadcast it during an activity, yes or no. Once you're done with those features, you can press the back button, get back to your widget, and then you can press back to go to your main screen.